On my way from Florence to Pisa, I decided to stop in this nice old city. San Gimignano is a small walled medieval hill town in the province Siena, Tuscany. It is famous for its medieval architecture, unique in the preservation of about a dozen of its tower houses, which form an unforgettable skyline. The historic center of San Gimignano is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. This place is pretty old. In the 3rd century BC, a small Etruscan village stood on the site of San Gimignano. In the 1st century, two patrician brothers, Muzio and Silvio, fled Rome for Valdesa and built two castles, Muzio and Silvia, now San Gimignano. In 450 AD, Bishop Geminianus, the saint of Modena, intervened to spare the castle from the destruction by the followers of the Attila the Hun. As a result, the church was dedicated to this saint. And in the 6th and 7th centuries, a walled village grew up around it. It was called the Castle of San Gimignano, or Castle of the Forest, because of the extensive woodlands surrounding it. From 929, the town was ruled by bishops of Volterra. In the Middle Ages and the Renaissance era, it was a stopping point for Catholic pilgrims on their way to the Rome. The city development was also improved by the trade of agricultural products from the neighboring hills. In particular, saffron, used both in cooking and dyeing clothes, and vernaccia wine, was pretty popular. This place is indeed unique. It feels like a time travel. And still, there are lots of people living here, in this historical part. The city is preparing to the Christmas. In 1199, the city made itself independent from bishops of Volterra and set about enriching the commune with churches and public buildings. However, the peace of the town was disturbed for the next 2 centuries by conflict between the Guelphs and the Ghibellines, and family rivalries within the San Gimignano. This resulted in competing families building the tower houses in increasingly greater heights. By the end of the medieval period, there were 72 tower houses up to 70 meters tall. At some point, local council decided that no tower should be taller than the Palazzo Comunale. This is one of the theories basically describing that all these towers were built due to vendetta, so that competing families could protect themselves still living in the city. Another theory says they were hiding from the tax collectors in those towers. So when tax collectors were there, people would just not open, saying it's enemy family trying to trick them. I think both theories could be true simultaneously. The local people believe that the towers were built for beauty and wealth, so that people could show to others how rich they were, but also to increase their property square meters, as the land is limited by the walls and extremely expensive. While the official patron is San Gimignano, the town also honors Saint Fina, who also is known as Serafina, who was born in San Gimignano 1238 and whose feast day is 12th of March. Once San Gimignano hosted Dante Alighieri in his role as ambassador of Guelph League in Tuscany. The city flourished until 1348, when it was struck by the Black Death that affected all of Europe, and about half of the townsfolk died. The town submitted to the rule of Florence. There was little subsequent development, and San Gimignano remained preserved in its medieval state until the 19th century. There are also some modern sculptures. It's good they are not in the very historical center. Landscapes are amazing. are several touristic shops and restaurants. The city makes very good impression. I totally recommend visiting this city. This is a true hidden gem of Italy. I'm going back to the parking along the town walls. Town walls preserved very well and look robust. Thanks for watching, don't forget to like and subscribe, and see you next time.